Everyday Alchemy. The sun speaks to his guide.
We sit in the house, and slowly the world we're living in is getting smaller, and all we say is, please, at least leave us alone in our living room. Just leave us alone. Well, I'm not going to leave you alone.
Here the sun speaks to his guide. I will now return to my father, for he can neither live nor act without me. The guide immediately answers the sun. I will not let you go down alone. I have led you from your father's bosom, and I must bring you there again, that he may rejoice in life with the virtue we will bring to him. They both stood up and started off, returning to the father's presence. When the father saw the sun, he rose up and cried, "This high peak of India lies a vessel. Guide and sun, soul and spirit, have climbed to the skies. The sun speaks to his guide." Can you hear it? Have you ever heard it? Looked hard enough, listened long enough, ran far enough to find it. Your purpose, your power, your destiny, your true self. I have, and I'd bet my bottom dollar you have too. We just have to remember how to read the symbols and signs every day. Alchemy, every day. I can't say it enough. You, me, we are all infinite, unlimited in our essence. It's not a matter of how we remember, it's a matter of when. What do you think all the movies about time travel and stuck in a continual time loop are about? All of us have incarnated into this material reality with the same purpose and the same fate. Where we are on this wheel of reincarnation is anyone's guess. It makes little difference. It's all still a circle, gods and dogs chasing tails. What better analogy could I give to you than that? The end ashamed of the beginning, and the beginning afraid of the end. On and on. That is until the dizziness sets in, the tailspin, the crash. Only to then realize the two were always one. What we don't repair, we repeat. The hurt just causes more hurt. Blind leading the blind. At this point, it should start making sense that either we or the world have been unraveled. The twisted knots of string theory made a really shitty sweater. One pull on any loose thread is all it takes. One shred of truth. After that, the metamorphosis gains momentum. You have started the process of self-realization within. Here at Plate 12, we see that self-realization leads to self-actualization. Our spirit is guiding our soul. The symbolism in every second speaks to you. You are now seeing the synchronicities. Things are starting to make sense. Everything serves a purpose to your higher self. In this way, our indoctrination has been transmuted and used for our education. To put it in religious terms, God created the logos, the light, the source code, the word, and the world. And despite what the devil may have you think, even he must use God's language, his symbols, his sons and daughters. The English language, for example, etymologically means that of the angels. Our spells are curse words. It's all been co-opted and corrupted, but not completely controlled or killed. It is through true understanding of ourselves we can find the origin. The original reason for our being. This plate represents a further distillation process in alchemy, where the soul leads the spirit to a high peak for a broader perspective. However, using the symbol of a bird, we can see that the higher we soar, the smaller we seem. This high peak of India represents the vessel of Hermes, the body, the holy temple inside every human. Deeper analysis of this metaphor specifically means meditation. The transpersonal self and the self-image of God. Symbols will always stand for that which you haven't completely understood yet. All the symbols and archetypical figures in which the process of individuation are embodied are but vehicles for the transcendent function. This function is to transform or transmute one thing into another, guiding each of our lives through our inner voice and subconscious, our personal guardian angel. The transcendent function has transcended the duality, creating harmony, unity, through the restoration of balance between your ego and your unconscious. Symbolically speaking, these are shown as the sun and the moon. Here, your higher self has taken your perspective to a higher plane of awareness. This is analogous with what has been termed a peak experience, a psychological breakthrough. These energize us with the understanding that anything is possible, teaching us the ability to transcend space and time through the upward mobility of our spirit in search of itself. These experiences have no defining terms. There's no certain recipe for self-realization. A peak experience is inherently self-validating, confirming our previous hypothesis regarding our higher self. Your guide might look similar to the one Lambspring left us, a wise old man archetype, a mentor, a teacher. It might not. The feminine aspect of this archetype is the muse. Symbolically, this can appear as a serpent, a butterfly, a circle, a ring, or star. Pay close attention to your dreams, visions, synchronicities, and brief moments of clarity for clues this guide will give you. The masculine interpretation of this play also represents the ability for the masculine polarity to overcome any obstacle, overpower, and outclimb our individual shortcomings. Whereas the feminine polarity is represented here by our guide, widening our awareness through connection with the whole. That's the point of all this, the place we all cross, the intersection of the ups and downs, the left and rights, the wrongs. This mountain is the meeting point where soul and spirit collide, cause and effect, life and death. That black hole will birth the brightest star, and the sun has risen. However, now that he has completed his quest, the son longs for his father. This represents the downward pull of matter. In meditation, this can be as simple as an itch or an ache, any interruption. Practically speaking, this is the tendency for the world's ability to obstruct our search for self. Without the body, our spirit would never be able to actualize the newfound realizations and discoveries. The king cries for his son. Without the infusion of spirit, matter grows mundane, meaningless. I know I've gotten stuck in these melancholy moods for years, for days. Now those days are done. I was a fool trying to change the world, but now I am wiser and working on changing myself. Truth be told, I don't really believe in the hero's journey, not in traditional terms. This is reality. It's not a movie. This is me, and I'm more than a simple story. Our journey is an inward one, a quiet quest within each of us, a war between what we have been told and what we will know. It doesn't make a difference if you are the dragon or the knight. The result is the same, for darkness is bound to light. It is only through these projections and dialogues of dualities that create the divide. And until you either psychically or physically act out each archetype, integrate and understand them, you will never become individuated. In closing of this chapter, the plate represents the following four levels of awareness. Spiritual. The soul is raised to the level of the spiritual world, yet the process is not complete. Matter has not embodied the soul and spirit. Therefore, the two must return to the body. Mental. The plate and text reference the importance of meditation. The daily practice of meditation will prepare the body for the eventual infusion of spirit and soul in every moment of being. Ritual leads to routine, and this constant self-care will cleanse any complexes or harmful habits we have formed. Emotional. The emotions are transmuted through the understanding of the universe around you. We are getting close now, and you are almost home. Along this path of alchemy, you have psychically played every role, So your imagination can integrate and understand the emotions of others without the attachment or interference of your own. Physical. Through the practice of meditation, you should start seeing a decrease in your appetite for material gratification. The hermetic principle, as within, so without, applies to everything, including the body. Individuation isn't for the faint of heart. Harmonize your thoughts first, then your words, then actions. Otherwise, someone else will always be pulling the strings, telling your story, twisting your words, betraying your body. Once we reach this stage of self-realization, we are incredibly close to self-actualization. The spirit must be guided by the soul, ensuring a safe return to the body. The sun and guide must return home.
Gift?
Yes. Sometimes empty page presents most possibilities.